was not last time, and not here only exceeding your own service.
Mm. So we, this one said, we do of the world, not only here. You know, you can hear lots of things nowadays in internet. You know, you wouldn't believe them. I look at my 13 years old, you know, grandson knows very well something we, you know, he doesn't know, we don't know. He just open up then the cell phone, then the, you know, open up. Okay, then the grandpa, this mean is like this. I thought he knows everything, you know. But really, he knows, you know, brain level. He knows the head. He knows. But actually, he doesn't do. You know, that's a problem anyway, nowadays. So that's why key is, you know, we just exercise, you know, exercise this one. Then also, like, benefit to exercise is obedience, okay? So that's kind of important, yeah. Okay, now, next one, 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 4. Okay, your eyes open up. Do okay, but not only do self. Also, you just hear is very important, but not only hear. Do something. Okay, so 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 4.
He that speaks in a tongue, he is himself, but he that professes it, he is the church.
Hmm. This is a very kind of important word here, or not familiar in the word. This Bible, this is also King James, old 1611, you know, 1611, so that's why almost 400 years old, you know, English, this one, ideas. It's a way of communicating with God that edify and build you. You know, of course, then, you know, if you hear the word of God, and also God is above our, you know, intellectual things, anyway. So then that's why this one said, it's a way of communicating with God that edifies and builds you up. Edify means edify. Edify means more, you know, power and virtue, you know. And if you look at it just like a regular web-style, you know, dictionary or something, you know, this one's a more, edify means exalt, you know, more deep meaning of this one. But anyway, God is sometimes deep than us, but Paul himself explained to us communication with God is a power and also more close to the God. You know, that means build you up. Okay, that's one. Okay, so then the next one, make it person. Okay, read this one.
Make it personal. Pray with us.
Pray with us. Meaning that, like I told you, told you, our spirit food is a prayer. Okay? And the prayer means, that's why I bring up then the more detail about the prayer. Matthew chapter 7 and verse 7 is a prayer, but the more, you know, kind of profound, you know, word, ask like our part, and shall be answer his part. That's why if you don't understand then what's going on, something, then you have to tell, you have to ask God, hey God, what's happening? Nothing happened, you know. That's kind of communication we should have, this one, you know. So that's why prayer is not just to pray something, more you understand what part you are and what part of God, okay? That's very important, okay? Okay, now next one.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, I want to be healthy. Please continue to teach me to use your method of lecture and exercise to change my habits and return to your will. I trust you and believe your word concerning my health. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah, this was a quite interesting, this one, okay? First, Heavenly Father, then we're more close to, okay, Daddy, you know, that's more close to the God, and not the, you know, almighty God, and the builder or create the whole world, and, you know, more like we close to the God, meaning, hey, Daddy, you know, that's kind of communication we need. You know, nothing really apart, because God created human being like Genesis 1:26-27 we read the last couple, you know, weeks ago. Then God himself created in his image, God's image. So that's about more close to the God, you know. That's what I look at this one. Then also I want to be healthy. That's God wants to, you know, healthy. So need exercise, of course. Then what's actually exercise? Please continue to teach me to use your method of laughter and the exercise to change my habit and result your will. I trust you and believe your word concerning my health. So God himself, you know, like the word of God said, concern about your health. I want you to be healthy, you know, healthy. So then you know, we got the spirit, soul, and the body we have. Like the first one, then like a spirit food, like we are talking about the prayer, but not just prayer or something. You expect something, meaning is ask. You gotta ask, you know. And also more deeper one than the seek. More seek, you know, detail about. And the knock means that wide open your, you know, physical realm or something. So through the spiritual to physical area, this one. So that's why very important, this one. Then spiritual food, this one. Okay, then the body food. Okay, body food, this one. Body food mean is not to just eat good food, organic food, extra money you pay, you know. That's not the only. Of course, very important. Like I told you, Trader Joe, friend of mine working, then not deceiving you, but they said very clean, everything clean, and you don't need to feel the you know, skin out, you can eat right away or something. And after that, friend told me, no, use water, then, you know, tap water to clean or something. Okay, that's not good, you know. So that's why you can't trust, I can't trust anything nowadays, and very, very, you know, difficult way to pick, you know, good food. But this one said, laughter does so much to repair the soul. So laughter is very, very important, this one. Laughter and the joy actually stick together. That's why this one said, joy of the Lord, your strength. You know, that's word of God we read before, right? Chapter 1 or something. Yeah. So that's why life of the joy help your, you know, physical body. That's what this Jackson really, you know, explained to us. And also, he's a very smart, you know, doctor. Then also deep into the scientific approach, this guy, you know. So that's why he said, exercise is very important, number one, you know, for the other food. And secondly, you understand the structure of our body. You know, last time I told you, cell, how big? Okay, one cell size for the 1,000 millimeter, so small. Okay. Then we study more. This one's a kind of, you know, cell. You know, this is a cell. Okay. Cell. You know, like this was a one. Size like this, right? Size like this. Then the interesting to know, this was more studied cell. This one's actually communicate to each other. Okay? Cell itself then communicate each other. So in other words, if you got the cell also what you call leg like this, okay? Dead cell is like this, no leg like this. So this was a Greek, this is a Cylon knee. Yeah, cell itself, okay? So, if you keep health, you know, nowadays, so many supplements you can find, but you have to be careful. Then, you know, some supplements, then cell, between the cell communication, then why need communication? Because you know, bad cancer cell like this. But this good cell communication each other, then destroy those cancer cells. Every single people now this room has a cancer cell, you know, believe or not. But in order to overcome cancer cell, you have to have immune system. That's very, very important, immune system. Okay? So that's why immune system, we call protein, you know, so much more detail, but anyway. And, you know, this is kind of overcome the cancer cell. Because last year there were three people, you know, died very close to my, you know, life, anyway. Cancer, died cancer, okay. Then sometimes very, very kind of difficult to understand, but I just tell you important things. Then physical exercise is very important. I never thought about before, but after I read this book, then I understand. Then the laughter is one of the good medicine for your life. So that's why every time then you work something, you know, stress all the time, that's not good for that, good for the, of course, brain and your body too. Okay, so that's why you have to be very, very careful. And the soul food, okay, this one, soul food, more like a word of God, this one. This is like a more prayer, right? Food. So this one. Body means the more like a strong, healthy cell. As well as laughter. Okay? So that's why, you know, if you acquaint, you know, friend each other, then the guy's so negative, then he never laugh at something, then that's not good for your friend, okay? So that's why this time go. Okay, now, what about the soul? Soul, this is more like a psychology, you know, people. Psychologically, more they are defined than what's actually food. But the, like my point, this one's more like a word of God. This one, okay. Okay, why I said that about food? Okay, Matthew chapter 4. Okay, open up Matthew chapter 4. Okay. Book of Matthew. Okay. Chapter 4. Verse 1. Okay. Verse 1 to maybe 6. Okay. So you open up the Bible, why don't you read chapter 4 and the verse.
Then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the desert to be tempted by the devil. After fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. The tempter came to him and said, "If you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, man does not live on the bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." Then the devil took him to the holy city and had him stand on the highest point of the temple. "If you are the Son of God," he said, "throw yourself down. For it is written, he will command his angels concerning you, and they will lift you up in their hands so that you will not strike your foot against the stone."
Yeah. Okay, this one said, Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, he replied, and the devil tried to attempt attempt to Jesus. Then verse 3, and the tempter came and said to him, if you are God's son, you know, very much clearly he defined then his power and his being or something like very clearly. So that's why the devil knows, you know, whole thing. And the tempter came and said to him, if you are God's son, of course he's God's son, son of God, this one. Okay? Command these stone to be made. Loaf of bread. This is also correct. He's a God, he can do it. You know, he created the whole world, this one. Jesus also involved, you know, first place than this one. So then this one's all he's hungry, he needs food, he needs bread, then all kind of situation this one, then we understand this one. Then the devil took him, if you are God's son, command these stone to be made, you know. Devil knows he's a miracle God. But he replied, this is a key Jesus applied. It has been written, man shall not live and be upheld and sustained by the bread alone. This is a key word. Bread alone. If he, you know, he change a stone to bread, then he live only like a, you know, living, you know, God need food and bread and that kind of life. But this one's Jesus himself said, he replied, it has been written, man shall not live and be upheld. Meaning that Jesus himself, not he feel, you know, hungry, feel hungry, you know, this one. So that's why this Jesus and the soul himself then walk by a face, word of God. That's what's said. It is, he said, it is written. Not the miracle God, you know, he performed the miracle. No. He himself said, it is written. So that's why this is a very good lesson to us. Okay, we walk by faith, not by sight. Mean is that we walk by the word of God. You know, that's actually soul food for us. Okay, so you don't want to eat the junk food all the time. You know, not the junk food, but this one, the junk food, meaning is that, you know, devil said storm. You know, you see stone all over the place. Then you just command the stone, then become bread or something. Okay? So that's not the way, you know, Jesus walked. He got the soul food. So that's why he's not gonna depend on the devil to, you know, support or something. Okay, next one. Chapter 3, you know, go back to the book, then chapter 3, how your body and the soul affect your spirit, okay? This is very, very, you know, more deep way to understand, but anyway, you can read. Chapter 3.
From
from cover to cover, the Bible is about the spirit, soul, and let's work to protect our bodies and our mind. We need deeply to focus on God's word. The scripture law synergy says if any two of you agree, this shall be done. Exercise is your tool, your wisdom, and should be kept clean and ready. From cover to cover, the Bible is about the spirit, soul, and body. God created Adam as...
Yeah, that first, first Thessalonians 5:23, we read the many times, but anyway, this time, then the word of God said, what's the word of God said? You know, like a soul food is word of God, like I said. So that's why you depend on word of God in order to live right, you know. That's what the, Jackson really emphasized for us. Okay, first Thessalonians chapter 5 and 23. Yeah, why don't you read this one? So this is a key word, and also this is a center of the word of God for this lesson. Okay, this lesson in 1 Thessalonians 5:23. You know, if Bible doesn't tell, then how we can follow the you know, God? Because God Himself then create the word of God and also Bible, you know, this one. Okay, go ahead.
May God Himself, the God of peace, sanctify you through and through. May your whole spirit, soul, and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Hmm. So you guys are seeking a peaceful life. You know, everybody peaceful life. Such this crazy computer, internet world, then very much craziness, but still seeking a peace. You know, last week, my another Korean pastor said he went to somewhere, okay, San Francisco or some place, okay. Then nice restaurant, you know, very nice restaurant, good food and everything. So he came back home. Then he opened up then his you know, internet. Then asking particular restaurant, ask him evaluation. Well, restaurants are good, bad, and okay, excellent or something. Then another food about food. You like a whole survey. He was so surprised. This is a you know, this Sunday, and he explained it. He said, what the heck? Guy knows my cell phone number. Then ask him, you know, all detail about it. So then he, after that, he got so upset. Why he knows my telephone number? And also, you know, email address or whatever. He looked at the, he got the phone, actually Google, iPhone, okay. Then he just researched a little bit. Nowadays, okay, folks, Google knows everything. Even he never gave his telephone. So then I met the last week, one of the friends, he came from the New York, and his son going to USC, you know, film school. So that's why we just matched together. I told him, why not? He's a more like a computer genius guy, New York. He used to have a farm, engineering farm. So then he said, okay, give me your cell phone. No, I don't want to give it. Okay, it's okay. He looked at myself. He found within 5 minutes, he knows my wife's name, even the age, where I live, how many sons, how many daughters you have, all kind of information within the 5 minutes he showed to me. So another word, this world is so dangerous and crazy, you know. Yeah. So then Google itself then knows everything. Okay, you have no hiding place, okay? Somebody, you know, even though you have boyfriend, girlfriend, or whoever, knows everything, you know. That's why I think you guys go Word of God, okay? Okay, this is extra, you know, gift, okay? Why I'm very, very much confident even in this crazy computer world? Okay, I show you the Word of God, okay? Now, 1 John, Book of 1 John, okay? You got a big benefit today, whenever you got to this class, okay? Chapter 4, okay, 1 John chapter 4, what's actually what God said? Verse 4. Okay, you open up.
Your dear children are from God and have overcome them, because the one who is in you is greater than the one who is in the world.
Yeah, you receive it? That's why I just read this one. I am not worried about anything because greater than the world. So I believe Christ, Jesus Christ, this one said, little children, I'm little children, okay? You are of God. You belong to Him, Jesus Christ, and have already defeated and overcome them, the agent of Antichrist, because He who lives in you is greater, mightier than he who is in the world. So you are greater than in the world, because Christ in you, you know, greater than in the world. So that's why you don't worry about it anyway. Yeah. So I'm not going to worry about anything. But anyway, I am so amazed that the guy knows everything, you know. Yeah. So that this is a world, okay. Okay, so next one. Okay, go ahead and read another few minutes.
God created Adam as a three-part being with all the parts working together. Then Adam sinned and broke the system. He first studied and seek God, but perhaps the least understood revelation in the Bible is the difference of the spirit, soul, and body. The spirit never dies. The spirit man lives eternally.
This was okay. Definition of the spirit. We know food. Spirit need food. You know, more like a prayer, and you know, Word of God. You know, internal Word of God meaning is very important. Then also soul, we are talking about the Word of God means that Jesus said it is written, and the body is very important, our soul, cell, and also exercise. This doctor really talking about when laughter, you know, your life, or joy. So then said, the joy of the Lord, your strength, power. Okay, you have to have joy. Okay, I don't know how many friends you have or, you know, parent or something. You gotta have a joy, okay? Show him that all. That's the, actually help your body food. Okay, go ahead, Lee.
Also, you have a soul and you live in a body. Jesus uses the pun of rich man and leper name Lazarus to teach about the spirit, soul, and body. These were their men whom the Westerners had known. Lazarus.
Okay, this are misspelled it's okay, both. Okay. Like he said, his nature, this, okay, the spirit is eternal. Like we learned this one. And also, never die. You know, that's what Bible said, let's thank God, you know. So that's why his nature was still intact. Because Lazarus, he died, and the rich man also died, according to the Bible. We open up about Luke 16, verse 19 to 31, said, rich man died, and also poor guy, Lazarus died, and both died. But Abraham's bosom, then, you know, this one said, the rich man's memory and his intellect were still very much alive, okay? Even after his body was dead. In fact, they are working better than when he was alive in the body. And the next paragraph is very important. His nature was still intact. He was still trying to boss around Lazarus and Abraham. Can you imagine? This is the Bible really clearly said our situation in this world and also future. You know, Bible really clearly said presence, of course past, who care past, but the past, presence, and the future. So that's why, that's why today, you know, we learn then the three part, spirit, soul, and the body, you know, three part.